Good morning. Welcome to worship this morning, and a special welcome to our visitors who are here for our confirmation service. Quick announcements before we begin. Next Sunday is our All Saints worship. So we'll be remembering those who have gone before us in faith, those saints who taught us how to live in faith. So we hope that you'll join us for that service. Also, next Sunday is my last Sunday at Our Savior, so that will be an interesting day.
Pastor Dave?
Yes.
Next week is Pastor Dave's last Sunday, and we want to celebrate and thank him for his ministry these last 8 years. So between services, we will celebrate, we'll honor him at worship, and we will celebrate with some good food in between services next Sunday to say thank you, Pastor Dave.
Continuing with announcements, we have a blood drive happening here at church on Tuesday. So if you see extra cars out in the parking lot, that's what's going on. We have a retired person's coffee coming up on Wednesday, November 6th at 9 a.m. The Welcome Bazaar is fast approaching on Saturday, November 9th. And then on that same day, on November 9th, we'll have a group going over to the Connections Shelter in Mankato to serve a meal. We also want to say congratulations to our confirmands who are affirming their faith today. We're very excited for them as they take this next step in their faith journey. And we add to our prayers a prayer of thanksgiving for the wedding of Sydney Olberg and Tim Madick yesterday. And we'll add the families of Rich Bauman and Dennis Wegner, who both passed away this last week. So please pray for all of those on our prayer list. Pray for peace in our world and for our church. Now I invite you to stand as you're able, and we'll join in our processional hymn.
Thank you.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever. Amen. Let us confess our sin and come to God for healing. We'll take a moment for reflection. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have honored you with our lips, but have harmed our neighbors with our tongues. The cravings at war within us cause conflict and disputes. In our desire to be first, we make distinctions among ourselves. We place the needs of the poor and the suffering last. In your great mercy, forgive us our sins. Draw near to us with grace in time of need, and turn us to follow in the way of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God promises to forgive our iniquity and to remember our sin no more. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, the source of eternal healing, your sins are forgiven. Amen. Now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We'll join in our hymn of praise. Let us pray. Blessed God, you have called these baptized young adults to affirm their faith in you. Give them joy in their confirmation, peace in their hearts, and courage as they live their lives for you. Send them and all of us into the world to serve you in everything we do, for the glory of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated, and thank you to our adult choir for our anthem today.
Thank you. The psalm for today is Psalm 46. We will read this psalm responsibly. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be moved, though its waters rage and foam, and though the mountains tremble with its tumult. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city, it shall not be shaken. God shall help it at the break of day. Nations rage, the kingdoms shake. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come now, regards the word of the Lord, and what desolations God has brought upon the earth. Behold, the one who makes war to cease in all the world, who breaks the bow and shatters the spear, and burns the shields with fire. Be still then, and know that I am God. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. The reading for today is from Romans chapter 3, verses 19 to 28. Now we know whatever the law says, it speaks to those who are under the law, so that every mouth shall be silenced, and the whole world may be held accountable to God. For no human being will be justified in his sight by deeds prescribed by the law, for though the law comes, the knowledge of sin. But now, apart from the law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed and is attested by the law and the prophets. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe, for there is no distinction. Since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, they are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith. He did this to show righteousness because in his divine forbearance he had passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous and that he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus. Then what becomes of boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by the law. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. Please stand as you are able for the gospel acclamation.
The Holy Gospel according to John chapter 8. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." They answered him, "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying you will be made free?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The Son has a place there forever. So if the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. And kids, come on up. We're going to gather around the baptismal font today. Come on up. We're going to come right over here. Oh, we're going to stand up. We could stand right here. Yeah, come on up. Well, this is so great. Some of you brought cousins with you today. I love this. Come on over. We're so glad you're all here today because this is a super special day in our church. And some of you are here for this reason because maybe you have a cousin or a brother or sister who is today affirming their faith, or we call it affirming their baptism. You see, when most of these kids were babies, some were maybe a little older, their parents brought them to be baptized. Quite a few of them were baptized right here at this font. Yeah, like Theo was. And I bet there's some other of you up here, too, who were baptized here.
And at baptism, their parents brought them because their parents wanted them to know God's promises. And so they would hear God's promises that day, and they wanted them to be raised in a church just like this, so they could hear all the stories of Jesus and the stories in our Bible. But when they were baptized, they heard these really great promises that their parents wanted them to know. And the promises are this, that God loves you, and God would always love them. And then they heard that God forgives them. And then they heard that anytime you need me, God says, I'm right here. You can call on me. I'm here. And then God said, you're going to be with me forever, that I'm going to give you eternal life. And so then they were baptized, and then they came to Sunday school, or they came to Linked. Yep, like Theo. And does anyone here, any of the rest of you go to Linked or Sunday school at your church? A lot of you do, yeah. So it's where you hear, learn a lot about God. So they came to Sunday school, they came to confirmation. Some of them went to Bible camp, or they went to New Orleans for the gathering, and they kept growing in faith and growing in faith. And then today's the day they say, I affirm that, yes, my parents brought me here, but this is what I believe too. And so it's a very special day where we'll pray with them and they will affirm their faith. And not just the faith of their parents, but it's the faith in their heart too. So let's have a prayer and you can repeat after me. Dear Lord, thank you for your promises. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for forgiving us. Thank you for this church. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Thanks for coming up today. Well, 10th graders and all who have gathered here for worship this morning, grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in us the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm our faith, guide our life, empower our serving, give us patience in suffering, and bring us to everlasting life. This is the prayer that we're going to be praying over each of our youth affirming their baptism today. And as the parents and sponsors who made promises at baptism, participate in this prayer by laying hands on the young person as we pray. That prayer is a powerful moment because I think we all recognize that life can be really joyful and life sometimes is challenging too. And in all of that, we need our faith to help us and guide us and give us courage. And we pray that for each confirmation student will hear this in that prayer. We pray that they will hear, God is with you. The Holy Spirit is active and moving in your life, inspiring you and giving you confidence in leading you where you can share your unique gifts and abilities. And that's for our 10th graders, but it's really for all of us. So our 10th graders were asked to write a faith statement or a faith story. And you're going to be hearing from each of them today, just a little snippet, because there are 24 of them. But today is also Reformation Day, and we remember the birth of the Lutheran Church and how our faith in God's grace and love made known to us in Jesus Christ. And those promises are given to us at baptism. So how do we learn these promises? After that baptism, how do we come to know this? Parents, sponsors, and church members all promised to teach them. Our confirmation students spoke about all of the ways they have been formed in their faith. So Regan said, Sunday school, VBS, Green Lake Bible Camp, First Communion, and confirmation have helped me in my faith journey. And one of the results of that, he told me, is I pray to Jesus every day. It's an important part of my nightly routine. And Shyla said, my great-grandma Olstead, she always encourages my family to come to church. She also tells me and proves to me that God is in our lives and makes me feel like a true child of God. And Allie said, doing anything with my church makes me feel uplifted and closer to God. and I can't imagine my life, what it would be like without my church and the friends my church gave me. For example, she talked about the trip to New Orleans and how that church event impacted her. Natalie said, "The youth group is important to me because they show me that even though I'm young, I still am an important asset to the church, and it keeps me involved, and I build connections with other youth." And then she talked about volunteering and knowing how much this church made an impact on her, and so it makes her happy, she said, that I get to volunteer and make that difference in the little kids at OSLC. And then Jet talked about sharing and growing in his faith this way. He said, "But now, through these many years of church services and Sunday school and confirmation, I have learned that God will always be there to catch me when I fall, and that God restores his soul." I mean, the church and people have impacted the faith. This is where they've learned the stories. Bible stories also shape our youth. Mitchell said, David and Goliath is my favorite Bible story. It shows that you don't have to be the biggest or the strongest, but you have to have the most heart. And he said that helps him in athletics to never give up and always get back up after a game, even when I'm feeling down about myself. And Jesslyn said the parable of the Good Samaritan is one of the most important stories in the Bible because it teaches us about compassion and helping others no matter who they are, and I love this part, even if they are different from us. And Jackson's favorite story is the feeding of the 5,000, where 5 loaves and 2 fish, Jesus managed to feed multitudes of people. And he said, "It's my favorite because Jesus is directly helping the people that are the lowest in society, and its generosity can be applied in our real life." And then Owen talked about a Bible verse, John 13:7, where he said, Jesus said, "You do not realize now what I am, but later you will understand." And he said, this really connects with me when I'm feeling lost or asking, "Why, God?" It's a reminder that sometimes we just need to trust the process. Things might not make sense now, but they will in the future. And then he referred to Noah's Ark. That trust and knowing, you know, what you've learned in these stories is important in our lives. Trusting God has made a difference in the lives of our young people. Learning these stories and knowing. Kira Kral said that trusting God means that Jesus is always in my life through good times and bad times, guiding me, showing me the right path, even when it's the hard path. Because sometimes isn't life hard? That's true. And Tanner talked about knowing Jesus was with him when he was younger and had surgery, but then he said, Jesus was by my side when my grandpa passed away. It was during COVID, and we all know how that was difficult. He said it was hard to be at the funeral, but Jesus kept me going and kept me strong. And Levi also talked about his grandpa. He said, I see Jesus as someone that is always there for me. He was there with me through my hardest time losing my grandpa to cancer. Jesus walking with me is a feeling that I am looked after and safe. And then Logan said, Jesus' death and resurrection means to me that even in really bad times, there's always hope that it can lead to good. I can always count on Jesus to help me in times of need. Sometimes, of course, feeling God's presence is just something we know. But other times, we feel that presence through people, don't we? Ian said, the people who are Jesus in my life are my family because they are always helpful, they give advice, and they make you feel better when things stink. He said a different word, but I'm going to say stink today. But it's true. I said, that's just sometimes the way you have to say it, isn't it? Life is really hard, and you have a family there to help you through it. McKenna said it was a tough time in her life, and it was her mom's ongoing and always support and a Wednesday worship message that stuck. And she said, from that moment on, I have always believed Jesus will be by my side no matter the circumstances. Jesus will guide me through my life. See, I think sometimes we look back, if we're older, we look back at our youth and we think, oh, those carefree days, how wonderful. But the truth is, our youth go through hard times too. They go through some very difficult things, and faith has already helped them through some of those times. The promise isn't that life is going to be perfect. I think they already know that. The promise is that no matter what comes your way, and Kate said it this way, that no matter what comes your way, Kate said, what real faith is when something or someone is pulling you away from God, you squeeze God's hand just a little bit tighter. Of course, our faith isn't just about us, is it? Jesus says in the gospel today that through him, we are no longer slaves to sin, but we are free. So the question is, free for what? Free to do whatever we want? I don't think so. I think a good way to look at this is to remember our baptism. When we are sent at baptism, to let our light so shine before others that they can see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. See, we don't have to earn God's love. It's a gift. And so now we're free to use all the gifts and unique talents we have to serve God and God's people. Colton said it this way, I see myself serving Christ every day by doing things to improve the quality of people's lives, like his neighbor, who he helps with yard work and snow removal because he can't do it on his own. Cain said, I see myself serving Christ in my daily life by being kind to others, helping those that are in need of a hand, and including everyone, this is really great, and including everyone like our church does for all who walk through the door. And Kira Sullivan said, serving Christ can be a simple task that anyone can do in their everyday life. At Our Savior's, I've been taught how to serve Christ, and within that, I've been able to pinpoint things I can do in my everyday life that serve God. On this Reformation Sunday, we're reminded that faith isn't stagnant. Not only are our youth growing, but we're constantly being formed and reformed too. And Taven has learned that in his one short year, he said, of being a member at Our Savior's. He said, my faith has changed a lot over the year I have gone to Our Savior's. Hearing all the stories of God helped me believe in God. Jesus has brought me light in both the dark and light times of my life. And Gracie said this about faith. It's perfectly okay to question faith in order to seek understanding. Faith is one of the most valuable gifts we can have as it provides a sense of purpose and hope. And yet in that, it's still okay to ask questions. That is how we continue to be formed and reformed. We are meant at baptism, we're baptized into a congregation, into the church. We're meant to walk through life together as the body of Christ. And we have that here for our young people. Megan said, my youth group, I've never felt judged by any of them. This church is special to me because it isn't like a normal church. Anyone is welcome here, and we have fun. And Eliana said, at this church, I feel like I can be myself and talk about my faith and not feel judged. My church family has become an important part of my life. Things like lock-ins and Christmas programs and Christmas hymns. And then Natalia said this. Whatever's been going on in my life, whether it's as bad as someone dying or as good as going to the ELCA youth gathering in New Orleans, Jesus was there with me every step of the way. And she said, a message from New Orleans sticks. So we had a speaker, Jacqueline Bicey, and Natalia is quoting her. When things get bad, share your scars anyways. Sparkle anyways. Know you are loved always. We all need that message today, don't we? We all need to hear this today, and we need to hear today, too, that what we are doing for our children and youth is so important. As parents and grandparents and church members and Sunday school teachers and pastors and leaders, our words and our actions show our young people God. And our open hearts and our listening ears to them For them, they will help them find their own words and their own path as a child of God. And I think in doing this, I think when we do that with our young people, we actually find that then we too are formed and reformed by their youthful energy and their passion for their faith and even their questions. I know these young people have taught me. They might have given me a couple gray hairs too, but they've really taught me. No, you know, they're terrific. But I want you 10th graders, now pay attention, because I want you to remember this. You are God's beloved child. Nothing you do can make God love you less. Nothing you do will make God love you more. God made you, you, the way you are. The light of Jesus has been shining in and through you since your baptism. So now go out always and let your light shine. In the classroom, in the choir, in the band, on the team, at home, here at Our Savior's, in your neighborhood, wherever you are in your corner of the world, let your light shine. Let it shine by living what you have learned, by living as Jesus taught. Amen. We continue now and sing our hymn of the day, Build Us Up, Lord. Please stand.
Dear friends, we give thanks for the gift of baptism as we come before God to make public affirmation of baptism into Christ. So let us pray. Next slide. Next slide. There we go. Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you that you have made us your own by water and the word in baptism. You have called us to yourself, enlightened us with the gifts of your Spirit, and nourished us in the community of faith. Uphold us and all your servants in the gift and promises of baptism, and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ. Amen. Please be seated. And we will now read the Bible verses and names of our confirmands. And as we do that, we invite those confirmands to come forward when their name is read. Colton John Anderson, Psalm 62:6. God alone is my rock and my salvation, my fortress, I shall not be shaken.
Tanner J. Backer, Psalm 56:3. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you.
Gracie Mae Baker, Romans 8:28. We know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose.
Logan Leonard Booth, Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Megan Elise Brutally, 1 Corinthians 13:13. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love.
Eliana Jean Caribou, Luke 18:27. Jesus replied, what is impossible for mortals is possible for God.
Natalia Harriet Fredrickson, Matthew 17:20. He said to them, because of your little faith, for truly I tell you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you.
Shiloh K. Gearing, Isaiah 41:10. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand.
Levi Marcus Hopp, Jeremiah 29:11. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope.
Mitchell Davery Hopp, Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Kane Eugene Johnson, 2 Chronicles 15:7. But you take courage, do not let your hands be weak, for your work shall be rewarded.
Regan Dale Johnson, Romans 8:31. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us?
Kira Ann Kroll, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life.
Ian Christopher Lee, Joshua 1:9. I hereby command you, be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
McKenna Leanne Laguerre, Deuteronomy 31:8. It is the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not fail you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed.
Owen Parker Rashi, Romans 8:11. If the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also through his spirit that dwells in you.
Kate Christine Schmidt, John 13:7. Jesus answered, you do not know what I am doing, but later you will understand.
Allie Grace Schneider, Galatians 2:20. And it is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
Natalie Harper Severson, Matthew 17:20. Jesus said to them, because of your little faith, for truly I tell you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you.
Jackson Ross Sheretz, Proverbs 27:17. Iron sharpens iron, and one person sharpens the wits of another.
Jesselyn Marie Skoglund, Luke 10:27. He answered, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself.
Kira Marie Sullivan, 1 Corinthians 13:13. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love.
Jet Jacob Volk, Psalm 23:3. God restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake.
Taven Stephen Wurzberger, Hebrews 12:1. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely, and let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us.
I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, to reject sin and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God?
I renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
You have made public profession of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth? And we'll ask each of you individually.
Colton, if you do keep those promises, please respond, I do, and I ask God to help and guide me.
I do, and I ask God to help and guide me.
Taven. I do, and I ask. And I ask God to help and guide me.
Tanner.
I do, and I ask God to help and guide me.
Jet.
Gracie.
Kira.
Logan.
Jesselyn.
Megan.
Jackson.
Eliana.
Natalie.
Natalia.
Allie.
Shyla.
Kate.
Levi.
Owen.
Mitchell.
McKenna.
Kane.
Ian.
Regan.
Kira. And now we invite your parents and sponsors to come up and stand behind you as we lay hands on and pray for these confirmants. It will be crowded, so just pack in here and stand behind them. And if you can't all reach your son or daughter, you can touch shoulders.
As we make our way forward, people of God, do you promise to support these sisters and brothers and pray for them in their life in Christ? We do, and we ask God to help and guide us. So let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin, and raise us to eternal life. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Colton the gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Tavin the gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Tanner the gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Jet the gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Gracie the gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Kira the gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Logan the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Jessalyn the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Megan the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Jackson the name of your Holy, the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Eliana the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Natalie the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Natalia the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Allie the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Shiloh the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Kate the name of the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Levi the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Owen the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, Empower him in his serving. Give him patience in suffering and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in him the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in McKenna the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Cain the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Ian the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Regan the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Kira the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Now, let us rejoice with these sisters and brothers in Christ. We rejoice with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all the world. Amen. Let's have them turn around and we'll share a round of applause to congratulate. Now that most of our confirmands are seated, I invite everyone to stand. Challenged and changed by God's word in Christ, let us pray for the church, the world, and all of creation. Eternal source of faith and life, confirm our faith. Inspire our work of life and love. Reform our church, guide our confirmands and our members. Join us together in mercy. Give us all that you see we need so that we can continue to serve you through serving others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Eternal source of love, grant peace and joy in marriages, relationships, families, and in all ways that we are bonded together. We give you thanks for the gift of marriage, especially that of Tim and Sydney, married here yesterday. Bless them with all that they need in their life together. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Eternal compassion, train us to respond to the cries of those in any kind of need. Give encouragement and comfort to those who cry out for relief from pain, sickness, or grief. We pray especially for Audrey, Russ, Eloise, Dixie, Al, Brad, Brian, Marilyn, Lyndon, Troy, Tracy, Carol, Vern, Sharon, Gabrielle, Marge, Jim, and all those that we lift up now out loud or in the silence of our hearts. We also pray for the families of Rich Bauman and Dennis Wegner as they mourn their passings. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in the saving grace you freely give, both now and forever. Amen. Let's share a sign of Christ's peace. Peace, everybody.
please be seated as they take the offering. On the fourth Sunday of the month, we always take an extra offering, a noisy offering, that goes to something outside of our church. Today, it will be going to Heart to Home. However, rather than passing that noisy offering, there are buckets at the back of the church for when you leave. This, we will take our regular offering and the noisy offering as you leave church. Also need the bread and wine. Please stand as they bring forward the offering. Let us pray. Merciful God, as grains of wheat scattered upon the hills were gathered together to become one bread, so let your church be gathered together from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. For yours is the glory, through Jesus Christ, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for for the remembrance of me. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us how to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Today for Holy Communion, I'll first invite all of our confirmation students forward, and they'll gather as they did before on the tan line. And the rest of you may be seated, and then communion will be walked through. So it means you'll come up here, you'll get the bread and the wine in the center, and go back to your pews, and then we'll go over and do the sides. So this is holy food for God's holy people. All are welcome at this table. You are welcome at this table. Please be seated, except for 10th graders. You can come and gather. Gotta go behind her. The body of Christ given for you. 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 Thank you. Please stand now for the communion blessing and prayer. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. O God, we give you thanks that you have set before us this feast, the body and blood of your Son. By your Spirit, strengthen us to serve all in need and to give ourselves away as bread for the hungry. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. We sing our sending song, very appropriate for affirmation of baptism, This Little Light of Mine. So let's let our lights shine. In peace, to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.